turned into wine. Open the eyes of the blind. There's no one like you, none like you. Into the darkness you shine. Out of the ashes we rise. There's no
and welcome to another chapel service online. I know it's a bit different from our normal, but this is the new normal that our Prime Minister has been talking about, things that will be changing after this pandemic. Washing of your hands, wearing masks, social distancing. It's all going to be new for you and for me. And for most people, we have to start adapting to some very new and strange things. Well, welcome to chapel today. And it's so good, and it's an honor for me to be able to share with you. I know a lot of you are going through some difficult times. Some of you are missing school, right? Some of you are missing your friends, definitely. Some of you are missing going to eat in your favorite restaurants. And some of you are missing going to the malls. But I know that you are making good use of Lazada and Zalora and doing your shopping online. These are all part of the new normal. But welcome to our chapel service today. I want to talk to you about the peace of God. The peace of God. You know, life may seem to be out of control, but it is not out of control for God. God is still sovereign. God knows what He's doing. He's in charge of everything that is going on. And we either don't trust God and we face anxiety and stress, or we believe in Him and we have that peace that He has promised to us. I know many of you are worried about your exams. I know the PT3 candidates are probably rejoicing. There's no PT3 this year, but I'm sure the SPM students are worried. Okay, you wanted it, your exams to be over and done with before December, and now it looks like you have to wait a little bit longer to the new year. And some of you, your entrances to colleges and universities may be delayed because of that. But instead of worrying about all these things, instead of stressing out, I want us to remember that even though things are out of our control, they are not out of control. Our God, the God who made the heavens and the earth, the universe, He's in control of everything. You know, there are people in the Bible like Daniel. You know the story, he was thrown into the lion's den. Now, people like Daniel would think that life is over, but you know, they trusted in God. And Daniel became the governor of Babylon. Then we see people like Joseph in the Bible. He was sold by his own brothers and treated very harshly, thrown into a dry well. And yet he became the prime minister of Egypt. There are other people in the Bible like Jonah, who was swallowed up by a whale, and he thought that his condition was so bad. But God raised him up to be one of a great prophet who saved a whole city in Nineveh. Then there's Jesus, our Lord and Savior, who was crucified on the cross at Calvary. And everybody thought that was the end. There was no hope. Everybody was in despair. Yet because God is in control, God is sovereign. Sovereign means He's the king of everything. He's the ruler of everything. He reigns from heaven. Jesus was not left in the tomb or on the cross. Bible says after 3 days, He rose again victoriously. And that's what we celebrated a couple of weeks ago on Easter Sunday. To say to the world that God lives. God is alive. He knows the things that you are going through. He knows the things that I'm going through. He knows it's difficult. Some of you may have loved ones who may be sick or isolated. Some of you are missing about school and you're worried about that. And He says to you, do not worry. Do not be anxious for anything. You know, the disciples were out on a boat in the Sea of Galilee one day. And there was a huge storm, and the boat was tossing and turning. There was lightning, there was thunder, and the disciples were afraid. And Jesus was sleeping at the back of the boat. And Jesus said to them, peace, be still. I am with you, I'm here. And Jesus just calms, he raised his hands and he said to the sea and the wind to be calm, be calm. You know, when Jesus is in our boat, when Jesus is in our lives, we do not have to fear. We do not have to be discouraged. He says in His Bible, I want to read that passage to you. He tells us about the birds. Are not 5 sparrows sold for 2 pennies? yet not one of them is forgotten by God. And indeed, the very hairs of your head are all numbered. Don't be afraid. You are worth more than sparrows. And in another part of the Bible, God talks about the birds, how they don't work, they don't get a salary, but yet God provides food for them every day. Isn't that wonderful to know that God loves you? In the Old Testament, he says he's got your name written on the palm of his hands. And he knows every hair on your head. One of my friends used to tell me, why should we worry if the boat should sink if God is the ocean? Why should we worry if the boat should sink if God is the ocean? Surely our plans are out of our control, but it is not out of control. God is in control of everything. Your life and my life, and the universe, the pandemic, the nations, the economy. You know, if you can just trust God and believe that He has your best interest in heart, you would have that peace that He has promised to you. Friends, Romans chapter 8 verse 20 says this, and we know that God causes everything to work together for the good of those who love God and are called according to His purposes for them. Look to Jesus for that peace. If you do not know Jesus, the Bible says in Acts that He is closer than you think. You know, it's time like this when we have a movement control order, when we're at home. We have a little bit more extra time, but I know some of you are really busy with school online. Some of you are busy, if you're like my son, having his own YouTube channel. You might be busy with that, but you know, one of the good things about MCO is that God gives us time to be at home with our families. And some of your families, parents might be asking you, don't waste your time. Maybe because you're using too much of handphone. Maybe you're locked up in your own room. Maybe you have your own YouTube channel. But you know, every day God gives us 86,400 seconds. 86,400 seconds. And we should use our time wisely while on earth. You know, I hope that during this time of the pandemic, of the restricted movement order, that you would seriously consider important things in your life. For those of you in Form 4, Form 5, even you're not sure yet what you want to study or what you want to become, that you'd use this time wisely to really search and determine what you'd like to do, how you'd like to spend the rest of your life, what you like to do, what colleges and universities and what courses you'd like to do. Because it's very important to set goals in your life. And you can start by setting this goal if you haven't decided already what courses you would like to study in university. I also think that you should take this time to seriously consider about your spiritual lives. You know, God really exists. God really loves you. And He wants a relationship with you. He wants you to call to Him. He's nearer than you can imagine. He wants you to invite Him into your heart, into your life. And I am 100% sure that when you do that, He will bring that peace that the world cannot give you, the peace that passes all understanding. And even in the midst of turmoil, even if the storm is raging, even though there's so much of things that are beyond our control, when the God of the universe comes into our lives, there will be serenity, there will be peace. You know, another thing about this MCO that is good, it gives you time with your family. And I want to pray that you would spend some quality time with your parents or with your brothers and sisters. Recently, in Australia, there was a guy who was driving a Ferrari who crashed, the police were chasing him. And when they stopped on the side of a road, a big truck came and killed the four police officers. But a few days later, the mother of this guy who was driving this Ferrari, she said, he has been estranged from the family. Estranged means he has separated from the family. The family had no contact with him for a long time. And that's a sad thing, because families are very important. Family is not just an important thing. Families are everything. I just spoke to a lady in my church. She is just celebrating her 90th birthday. She's 90 years old. And I asked her, what do you think is the most important thing in your life? And she said, without thinking about it, that family is the most important. Friends, I pray that you would spend some real quality time with your family during this MCO. Talk to your parents. I know some of you think that you know more than your parents. That's fine. At this age, maybe in terms of electronic gadgets and stuff like that, you probably do. But in terms of wisdom, in terms of experience, your parents probably can teach you a few things if you're willing to learn. Ask them about their parents, about their grandparents, and have some very good conversations together. Eat together, help around the house, play board games together, laugh, and enjoy this time that is good quality time alone in with your families. You know, before the pandemic, I think we were too busy just running up and down with lots of different things. Our parents were working hard. Both parents were working. We were just coming in. There's tuition. And now everything is from our homes. And it is part of the plan of God that we should build strong relationships at this time. So don't despair, my friends. Love the Lord your God. You know, if you want to know more about Jesus, you know, you can just go on Google online. How can I become a Christian? How can I know Jesus more? Or you can Google about the Bible, or you can read the Bible online. And I pray that during this MCO, it will be such a productive time for you and for your family, for your school. So let's bow our heads in prayer. Father, we just thank you again that we can meet today in this way, to be reminded again that you are sovereign, that things are not out of control, but everything is under thy control. Everything is under your control. Father, we just love you. We want to pray for Wesley School, for its students, for its teachers, for its staff. We thank you, Lord, that our lives are in your hands. Lord, you lead us and you assure us that everything works together for the good for those who are in Christ Jesus. Give us that peace that the world cannot give. Give us that peace that even though we may be fearful, even though we might be in doubt, even though we might be scared and frightened, Father, even though we may be discouraged or stressing out or a lot of things, we pray for your peace and your comfort to be with us and upon us. For you hold the future and we can face tomorrow. Thank you, Lord Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. So God bless you, and I hope to see you all again soon.
tonight that nothing is impossible for our God. Absolutely nothing is impossible for Him. So Lord, right now we ask You to come and do the impossible. What man thinks is impossible, would You come tonight and show them that with You, nothing is impossible. Who would like to see that tonight? Come on, these three words we're singing, I believe, it's actually two words. I believe in You, four words. It's a very simple sentence, but it's a declaration of our faith tonight that says, God, no matter what I'm going through, I believe in You. I believe You can do all things, that nothing is impossible for You. So can we declare this tonight? Can we declare it? Come on, let's sing it together. I believe. Cause I believe.
I believe.
Oh yeah, I can feel it. We believe You can do all things. I believe.
I believe. I believe. I believe in You. I believe. I believe.
I believe.
I believe. I believe in You.
Woo!
I believe.
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 I believe. I believe in You. Thank you, Jesus.